What can happen is that if there's some wax that's in there, and then the water gets trapped behind the earwax, if you shove a Q-tip in, you'll end up shoving the wax deeper and trapping the water. The cheapest and easiest way to remove it is tilting your head down and pulling on your earlobe and kind of wiggling it. Or you could put your finger into a towel and mop the water out of the ear canal with the towel. All of the products that are out there are basically rubbing alcohol if you look at the ingredients on the bottle. You can buy a very inexpensive, like 99-cent bottle of rubbing alcohol and buy yourself a small dropper and then drop 3 to 5 drops in your ear and the alcohol helps to evaporate the water. Do this laying down with the ear that's clogged up and you apply 3 to 5 drops of rubbing alcohol into the ear, wiggle that earlobe a bit. Let it sit for about 10-15 seconds, and then turn your head to the opposite side so that the ear is now downward, and hopefully that water and alcohol runs out. If there's pain, if there's persistent fogging, if you're not hearing well, if the ear is ringing or buzzing, or if you're dizzy, those are all signs that you need to go see a doctor. They attempt to use water pressure to evacuate the ear canal. I'm not a fan of that because it can cause a perforation of the eardrum, and the water can lead to an outer ear infection, and the whole procedure can be very uncomfortable. If an individual has no health insurance, they would likely be able to call up a doctor's office and negotiate a fee, probably ranging from about $50 to $80.